Day number 9 of the government shutdown now, still no end in sight, and the Carolinas are about to feel a major impact because of the lack of funds. In fact, the longer the shutdown, the deeper that impact, and the impact has definitely already come to the Carolinas.
Well, today, North Carolina ran out of money for women, infants, and children food vouchers, known as WIC. News 4's Pearl Josie joins us from Asheville now.
Employees at Buncombe County's Health and Human Services say the shutdown means every day around 100 people are not getting the food benefits they need for their families. And that's just the office in Asheville.
Good afternoon. This is Kayla. How can I help you?
Kayla Kexel works for Buncombe County HHS. She's also a mother, grateful for the help the WIC program provides her.
Oh, it's absolutely an essential service, I would say. I mean, it supplements people's nutritional needs in this community.
Usually, WIC recipients receive vouchers for groceries for nutritional assistance. They provide foods such as milk, eggs, cereal, fruits and vegetables, and baby formula. But starting Wednesday, DHHS had to stop giving out vouchers in North Carolina.
I felt sad that there's something there that is a service that's provided that's very important to myself and to so many other members of the community.
Director Gibby Harris says WIC services will still be available.
People can need to continue to come in because we'll be putting them on a wait list once they're eligible. That way, once we're able to provide vouchers again, it'll be immediate.
Clients could also get some outside help until the vouchers come through. Local HHS departments are working with area charities to help mothers get the things they need for their children and babies, like formula. Pearl Joshi, WYFF News 4, Buncombe County.
Laura Pearl, thank you for that. And South Carolina is dealing with the same challenges. DHEC says it's going to keep its WIC program until October 31st. And since there's no end in sight to the shutdown right now, the department is dipping into agency savings and asking the employees to make sacrifices, which could ultimately result in furloughs.